Atlantic Broadband Cable, in cooperation with the South Union Township Supervisors, presents the South Union Township Sports Network. Today, via tape delay from the Beener Baseball Field here in Hutchinson, it's Midget League Baseball time as the Clark Giants meet the HARC Reds. Hi, everybody. I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupain. We welcome you aboard for today's game. South Union Township Sports Network coverage is brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring Township Supervisors Bob Schiffbauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband Cable, Armstrong Cable, and our friends at CUTV, including Gary Smith. Again, I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupain. We'll be back with the first pitch after this message.
Diane Zinn is a lifelong resident of this area and has been a full-time real estate agent for 20 years. She is an associate broker at Coldwell Banker Laurel Ridge Realty and has been a multi-million dollar producer agent. Considering a relocation to our area, Diane can be helpful in specific areas that might be of interest to you, guiding you in buying that perfect home for your family and providing mortgage avenues for financing your dream home. If you need a market value for your home, this service is also provided with the knowledge that only a full-time realtor can provide in our current sales market. Diane will take the necessary time to help you find that ultimate dream home and will also take the time to market your home to get the best possible market value for you. Look for a full-time realtor with integrity, professionalism, and the knowledge of the real estate market. Call Diane Zinn today at 724-437-7100.
It's HARC Midget League Baseball here on the South Union Township Sports Network. The Giants taking on the Reds. The Giants to bat here in the top half of the first inning. And it'll be Hunter Bonsley leading things off. He'll be followed in the lineup by Evan Petrovich. Brody Pavlico batting third. Thomas Rankin batting fourth. Aaron Broadwater batting fifth. Parker Clements batting sixth. Will Schnatterly pitching and batting seventh. Logan Holton batting eighth. Colton Masico batting ninth, Darren Dunn batting 10th, Jaden Tucker batting 11th, and Matt Venick batting 12th for the Giants. Defensively for the Reds, it's Tyler Plebin in left field, Thatcher Wilson in left center, Tyler Hager in right center, and Zelig Redman in right around the horn, Matt Schwartzfeger at third, Jaden Ringer at short, Ryan Kiefover playing second base, Cyrus Potkel playing first, Carson Scott on the mound for the Reds, and Grant Scala catching for the Reds. The Reds entering this game with a 4-1 record. The Giants out of the Clark League entering this game with a 2-2 record. The Giants coached by Tom Rankin. Jason Scott, the head coach of the HARC Reds. And we're just about ready to play some baseball on this windy early evening here in Hopwood at the Beaner Field. 212 down the left field line. 230 to the deepest part of the park. And 200 down the right field line as Carson Scott finishes up his last couple of warm-up tosses. If you notice out there, they have a new portable pitcher's mound for the HARC Midget League this year. And Carson Scott finishing up his last couple of warm-up tosses, and we'll get this Midget League game underway between the Reds and the Giants here in Hopwood this evening. These teams have both been plagued with a number of weather postponements early on in this wet spring. The forecast next week expected to dry out a little bit. These teams will try to get back on schedule. Last throw down there for the Reds, and we'll get this game underway as Hunter Bosley will step in. The Giants to bat 12 here today. Of course, they play 10 in the field. The Reds with just 10 players in the lineup, so everybody that's batting will also be in the field throughout the course of the game. Nick Lancaster calling the balls and strikes. Luke Wallace, the base umpire here today, as the coaches go over the last couple of ground rules with Nick and Luke. Of course, the Clark Giants don't play here much. Play most of their games over in Oliver, North Union Township. That's Tom Rankin having a little discussion down there with Jason Scott. It looks like they're finally set to go. And we'll get this contest underway between the Giants and the Reds here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Brian Morozak alongside Jerry Dupe. Nice to have you along with us for some HARC Midget League baseball action. As Hunter Bosley will step into the box to lead things off for the Giants. Bosley deep in that batter's box. First pitch here from Carson Scott is outside for ball one. Carson quickly back on the mound. 1-0 pitch on the way. Swing and a miss there from Bosley to even the count at 1-1. Carson set again. 1-1 pitch on the way. That pitch in there for a strike. 1-2 now, Carson Scott to Hunter Bosley here in the top half of the first inning. Now the 1-2, and that's in there for strike three. So Scott K's Bosley to start this game. Now Evan Petrovich will come to the plate. Petrovich playing shortstop today for the Giants. Scott will wind and fire the first pitch. Just low and outside for ball one. Now Scott's 1-0 on the way. Swing and a miss. Petrovich chasing that one. Evens the count now at 1-1. Scott working quickly. Winds and fires the 1-1 here. Swing and a miss again from Petrovich. Count out 1-2. Scott looking confident early on. 1-2 pitch here, and this ball is chopped back to Carson. Goes between his legs, played there by Jaden Ringer, but his throw over to Cyrus Potkel not in time. So we'll give Petrovich an infield single. And the first hit of the game. Now Brody Pavlicko will come to the plate. He'll swing at the first pitch and pop it up in foul territory. Cyrus Potkel trying to charge on and able to make the play right in front of our camera location. Counted 0-1. Now the 0-1 pitch low and outside. Evens the count at 1-1. Scott to Pavlik. Goes to work here with one out and Petrovich on first. You're in the top half of the first inning. 1-1 on the way. That one didn't miss by much. Count now at 2-1. Scott in a groove. Delivers the 2-1 pitch, and that one hits the back of Pavlicko. He's all right. Good sportsmanship out of Scott. That does give the Giants runners on first and second with one out here in the top half of the first inning, and the cleanup hitter, Thomas Rankin, coming to the plate. Rankin catching today for the Giants. Son of the head coach, Tom Rankin Sr. And Thomas here swinging a miss on the first pitch from Carson Scott. Count it 0-1. Now Scott's 0-1, another swing and a miss out of Rankin. Count now at 0-2. Now Rankin with two strikes on him. Scott delivers the 0-2, swing and a miss, strike three. Second strikeout of the inning for Carson Scott. And now two down with two runners on and Aaron Broadwater coming to the plate. Broadwater, one of two designated hitters in the lineup to start the game along with Brody Pavlicko for the Giants. The table set for him here, though, with two runners on. The first pitch from Scott, swing and a miss from Broadwater. Runner going, throw down to third, not in time. Stolen base there for Petrovich. Now runners on the corners. The 0-1, swing and a miss, strike two. Now two strikes on Aaron Broadwater. And Scott set with the 0-2. That one missing low and outside. Count now 1-2. Scott to Broadwater with two outs here in the top half of the first inning. Still scoreless, but the Giants threatening. 1-2 on the way. That ball high and inside evens things up now at 2-2. Scott to Broadwater. 2-2 on the way. That one missing low, so we'll go 4-3-2. Scott needing a strike here. 3-2 pitch, ruled ball four. So that loads up the bases. And Parker Clements will be the sixth Giant to come to the plate here in the top half of the first inning. First pitch from Scott is outside for ball one. The game plan for the Reds coming in for Scott to go the first three innings and Jaden Ringer to close out the game. Just swing and a miss out of Clements to even the count at 1-1. The Reds head coach Jason Scott said he didn't expect too many other changes today, but we'll see how the game goes on for the Reds. Another strike there for Scott, and the count now at 1-2. Now the 1-2 pitch, and that ball just foul tipped by Clements to stay alive. Didn't catch much of it, but enough to stay alive with the bases loaded. Now Scott's 1-2 on the way. Swing and a miss, strike three. So the Giants leave the bases loaded here in the top half of the first inning. Three strikeouts from Carson Scott, and we'll head to the bottom of the first. Scoreless Giants and Reds. Midget League action here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Scoreless set it to the bottom of the first inning. The Reds coming to the plate. Carson Scott lead things off. He's pitching today. Jaden Ringer's batting second. Thatcher Wilson batting third. Cyrus Potkel in the cleanup spot. Grant Scala batting fifth. Matt Schwartzfeger batting seventh. Behind him is Ryan Kiefover, Ty Pleben, Tyler Hager, and Zelig Redman. Defensively for the Giants, Matt Venick in left, Parker Clements in left center, Logan Halton in right center, and Colton Masico in right. Around the horn, Jaden Tucker at third, Evan Petrovich at short, Darren Dunn at second, Hunter Bosley at first, Will Schnatterly on the mound, and swinging there at Schnatterly's first pitch and sending it foul is Carson Scott. Schnatterly on the mound and Thomas Rankin catching for the Giants. And as we said, the Reds pitcher Carson Scott at the plate fouled off the first pitch from Schnatterly. Now swings here and sends this one in a left field. So leadoff single for Carson Scott. He might be looking for two. Scott now hung up here between first and second. Throw back to first. And the ruling is out. Bosley hanging on. So Scott getting a little aggressive on the base paths. And the Giants with a throwback over to Bosley, nailing Scott off the first base bag. To credit the Giants with solid defense there. Scott gets a single to left field. And then picked off the first base bag on the throw. And now Jaden Ringer at the plate with one out and nobody on here in the bottom half of the first inning. Took ball one from Schnatterly. And the 1-0 on the way misses outside. Count it 2-0. Schnatterly likes Scott on the other side, working quickly. 2-0 pitch, swing and a miss there out of Ringer. Count it 2-1. And the Giants entering play today with a 4-1 record. Jason Scott, their head coach. The Giants out of the Clark League with a record of 2-2. Another swing and a miss out of Ringer to even the counts. At 2-2. Now Schnatterly's 2-2 pitch. And just getting a piece of it to stay alive. There is Ringer. Schnatterly's 2-2 again. And Ringer pops this one up to shallow left. And it'll drop in the Bermuda Triangle there between Petrovic, Clements, and Venick. So a one-out single for Jaden Ringer. Now Thatcher Wilson will come to the plate. Wilson playing left center field today for the Reds. The first pitch from Schnatterly misses outside for ball one. We'll see how aggressive Ringer is on the base paths. Schnatterly's 1-0 to Wilson. Misses high. Count now at 2-0. Here and there for a strike. Count at 2-1. Two-one pitch. Just fouled off there by Wilson. Count now even at 2-2 with Ringer on first and one out. Here in the bottom half of the first inning, this game's still scoreless. The Giants left the bases loaded in the top half of the first. 2-2 on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. So down goes Thatcher Wilson, first strikeout recorded of the game for Schnatterly. And now two away with number 10, Cyrus Potkel, coming to the plate. First pitch to Potkel, and Potkel line drive, a glove down by Darren Dunn for the third out of the inning. So the Reds strand Jaden Ringer will head to the top of the second, scoreless between the Giants and the Reds. HARC Midget League action here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer would like to wish all the HARC baseball players good luck and have a fun baseball season this year.
Heading to the top of the second inning, the Giants and the Reds scoreless here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Will Schnatterly, Logan Halton, and Colton Masico due up here for the Giants. The Giants sent six men to the plate in the top half of the first inning, but were unable to pick up a run, leaving the bases loaded. Evan Petrovic with an infield single. Brody Pavlicka was hit by a pitch. Aaron Broadwater walked. The Giants unable to bring home a run. They'll look to have more success here as far as driving in runs here in the top half of the second inning, and Will Schnatterly takes the first pitch low for ball one from Carson Scotts. Scotts 1-0. That pitch misses. Count now at 2-0. Scott pitching to his fellow mound mate, Schnatterly. 2-0. That pitch misses inside. Count now at 3-0. Scott's looking to find the strike zone. 3-0 pitch in there for a strike. Schnatterly appeared to be taking all the way. Now the 3-1. And there for another strike, so Scott bouncing back. Count now full 3-2, Scott to Schnatterly. The payoff pitch is outside for ball four. Second walk of the game issued by Scott puts Schnatterly on with nobody out. You're in the top half of the second inning. And Logan Halton coming to the plate. Halton playing right center field today for the Giants. First pitch, Scott to Halton, in there for a strike, 0-1. See how aggressive Tom Rankin and Will Schnatterly are on the base paths. Rankin, of course, the head coach, coaching third base for the Giants. Count now 1-1, Scott to Halton. 1-1 pitch, low and outside. Count now at 2-1. On the way, misses inside to Halton. Ball gets away there from the catcher, Scala. That will allow Schnatterly to get down to second in the scoring position. Count now 3-1. Scott looking to avoid back-to-back walks here to start the top half of the second inning. Big 3-1 pitch here on the way, but misses low for ball four. So back-to-back walks issued by Scott, putting Schnatterly and Halton on. And now Colton Masico will come to the plate with two on and nobody out. Here in the top half of the second inning, this game still scoreless between the Clark Giants and the HARC Reds. Now Masico at the plate, swings at the first pitch, sends it foul. Left of third base. Track down the loose ball out there. Send it back to Scott, who hop back on the mound. 0-1 pitch, and sending this one to short is Masico, and a nice defensive play there from Jaden Ringer, sending it over to Schwartzfeger for the force out at third. So it goes as a fielder's choice, 6-5. Retire. The lead runner, Schnatterly. So now you have Masico on first, Halton on second, one out in the inning, and at the plate, the lefty, Darren Dunn. First pitch misses inside and running down to third and sliding in safely. There is Logan Halton as the ball got away from the catcher, Grant Scala. Now the 1-0, swing and a miss there out of Dunn. Evens the count at 1-1. And the Giants batting 12 here today. Dunn in the number 10 position in the batting lineup. That pitch missing outside. Got now 2-1. Scott to Dunn. 2-1 pitch on the way in there for a strike. Evens the count at 2-2. With one out here in the top half of the second inning. 2-2. Dunn swing and a miss. Strike three. Now two away. Descott trying to bounce back again, as we mentioned in the top half of the first inning. The Giants left the bases loaded. Here they have runners on the corners, and now Jaden Tucker, the Giants' third baseman, coming to the plate. First pitch to Tucker, swing and a miss, strike one. Scott with Tucker off balanced after that pitch. 0-1 on the way. Misses inside. Count now even at 1-1. Scala lost that ball momentarily, able to get it back, and fires it back to Scott. Next pitch to Tucker. This is outside. Count out 2-1. Scoreboard says 3-0. It's incorrect. It's 2-1 right now. The 2-1 pitch behind Tucker. And now attempting to run down to second is Masiko. He'll make it there safely as the throw bounced to the right of the shortstop, Jaden Ringer. Now the count of 3-1. The pitch to Tucker. Tucker a swing and a miss there. Count now full of 3-2 with runners on second and third and two outs here in the top half of the second inning. Payoff pitch on the way, and that's low for ball four. That's the third walk of the inning issued by Scott in the fourth of the game. And the Giants, who left the bases loaded to end the top half of the first inning, have them loaded again with Matt Venick coming to the plate. First pitch to Venick is high for ball one. Scott and the Reds trying to escape again here in the second. 1-0 pitch in there for a strike to even the count at 1-1. One one here, just misses low and outside. Count out 2-1. That pitch in there for a strike evens things up at 2-2. Now the 2-2 pitch on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. So in back-to-back innings, the Giants leave the bases loaded to end the inning. Scott and the Reds escape again, and we're still scoreless heading to the bottom of the second inning. Giants and Reds, HARC Midget League action here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Grant Scala, Matt Schwartzfeger, and Ryan Kiefover due up for the Reds here in the bottom half of the second inning. This game's still scoreless. And on the mound, Will Schnatterly misses on the first pitch to Grant Scala. Now the 1-0, swing and a miss there out of Scala. Evens things up at 1-1. Scala catching today for the Reds. His first plate appearance of the afternoon. Now the 1-1. That one fouled off by Scala. Count at 1-2. One really gusting up right now. Some storms expected later on tonight. The wind blowing out to right field at the moment. Pretty good gusts at 20 to 25 miles an hour, and that one popped up by Scala. It will drop in behind the second baseman, Darren Dunn. So Scala getting aboard. And the Reds in business here in the bottom half of the second inning. With Matt Schwartzfeger coming to the plate. The Reds third baseman. No swing and miss of the first pitch here from Schnatterly. Counted 0-1. Now the 0-1 on the way. Misses a low, and it gets away there from the catcher, Rankin. Throw down to second, not in time. So Scala moves into scoring position here for the Reds. Count at 1-1, and this one ripped to first. Hunter Bosley, though, making the play, steps on the bag for the out, 3 unassisted. To retire Schwartzfeger for the first out of this bottom half of the second inning. And now Ryan Kiefover coming to the plate. Kiefover batting from the seventh position in this Reds batting order. First pitch, high for ball one. Grant Scala now down at third. As the Reds searching for the game's first run. Swing and a miss there from Kiefover. Next pitch from Schnatterly. Ruled a strike after a little check swing there from Kiefover. Kiefover now with two strikes on him. We'll have to protect the plate. That one fouled off as Kiefover stays alive. Schnatterly regrouping. Next pitch on the way. Ground ball right back to the pitcher. Schnatterly makes the little flip over to first for the out. But Kiefover able to drive in Scala for the game's first run. So the play goes 1-3. But Kiefover picks up an RBI. And now two away with a run across here in the bottom half of the second inning. And Ty Plevin coming to the plate. First pitch from Schnatterly, low and outside for ball one. Base is now empty. Now the Reds getting the game's first run across. 1-0 pitch in their first strike. Now 1-1, Schnatterly to Plevin. Tyler Hager in the on-deck circle for the Reds. 1-1 pitch, low and outside, count now at 2-1. That one, one hopping. Back to the catcher, Thomas Rankin, and the count now at 3-1. Three-one to Plevin. Ruled ball four. So Ty Plevin drawing a two-out walk here in the bottom half of the second inning. First walk of the game issued by Schnatterly. Now Tyler Hager will come to the plate. Hager takes the first pitch inside for ball one. Now the 1-0. Misses again, counting out 2-0, Schnatterly to Hager. Swing and a miss there from Hager, counting out 2-1. Swing and a miss. Counting out even at 2-2. A run already across. 2-2 pitch, low and outside. Got now 4-3-2. Now 3-2 pitch, high and inside for ball four. So Schnatterly with back-to-back walks issued with two outs here in the bottom half of the second inning. And I'll bring up Zeliger Redman. Batting from the number 10 position in this Reds batting lineup. First pitch from Schnatterly. Swing and a miss from Redman. Count it 0-1. Wind continues to gust. 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, strike two. Now Schnatterly's 0-2. Swing and a miss, strike three. So Schnatterly with his second strikeout of the evening, sending down Redman. Well, the Reds do pick up a run here in the bottom half of the second inning and lead the Giants 1-0 as we move to the top of the third here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Creditors calling you day and night? Your debt overwhelms you? Although you may feel that you're in a hopeless situation, Zebulun Mihaljev & White can help. We're a full-service local bankruptcy firm that knows what a difficult time this is and what to do to help you get a fresh start. Call Zebulun Mihaljev & White today for a free consultation. Your hometown bankruptcy firm. Call us today.
Don't borrow more money until you talk to Zebulun Mihaljev & White.
Top of the order, duo for the Giants, Hunter Bosley, Evan Petrovich, and Brody Pavlico. Reds leading the Giants 1-0. Midget League Baseball here on the South Union Township Sports Network. The Reds from the HARC League, the Giants from the Clark League. And Carson Scott set with the first pitch here to Hunter Bosley. And Bosley, a line drive, will get through on the right side, past Ryan Keefe over in the right field. Zelig Redman on to throw it in there for the Reds. So a leadoff single for Hunter Bosley to start the top half of the third inning. Not only the second hit of the game on the Giants side, as the Giants look to bounce back after yielding a run in the bottom half of the second inning. Now at the plate and swinging at the first pitch, Evan Petrovic, and he'll send this one in a left field. So back-to-back hits for the Giants here to start the top half of the third inning. The Giants, despite having only one hit entering this inning, have stranded six men already through two innings. They left the bases loaded in both the top half of the first and the top half of the second inning. Now a runner going here and down to third is Hunter Bosley. So the Giants getting aggressive here on the base pass with runners now on the corners with nobody out. And Brody Pavlico with a play. He'll pop this one up. The ball lands in fair territory. It was touched by the catcher, Grant Scala. And the throw down is second, not in time. Now attempting to run home is Bosley. And the Reds kind of sleeping out there a little bit. And Bosley will score in this game, tied at one. So Pavlico's ball touched in fair territory. And now at the plate, Thomas Rankin grounds this one to third, and the Reds without a play. That'll load up the bases for the Giants again. So a little confusion defensively out of the Reds here in the top half of the third inning. Four straight hits, a run across. This game tied at one. Now the bases loaded. And Aaron Broadwater coming to the plate. The Giants have been aggressive here, swinging at early pitches. Broadwater, though, taking the first pitch here from Scott for a strike. The wind now blowing up some of the infield dirt a little bit. 0-1 pitch. Broadwater fouling this one off. Count now at 0-2. Broadwater walked back in the first inning. Now the 0-2 pitch here, Broadwater swinging a miss, strike three, so much needed out out of the Reds. And they're going to actually rule that ball was tipped. So Broadwater, another opportunity to redeem himself. No K, and Broadwater back at the plate. This pitch misses outside. Count out 1-2. Pitch from Scott to Broadwater. Check swing did not go around. The count now even at 2-2. And a 2-2 here from Scott. Outside, and we're full of 3-2. Nowhere to put Broadwater with the bases loaded. 3-2 pitch on the way, and that's low for ball four. So when it appeared that Broadwater had struck out, ends up getting another opportunity at the plate. He'll be credited with an RBI walk. Evan Petrovic scores. Second run of the inning coming across for the Giants, and Parker Clemens will be the sixth Giant to bat here in the top half of the third inning, and he'll take the first pitch outside for ball one. So the Giants finally capitalizing on some of the early opportunities that have been granted their way here in this contest. That last pitch fouled off there by Clemens. The scoreboard going a little haywire right now. Showing double 88s on each side. Next pitch low and outside. Count it 2-1. It is a 2-1 lead as well now for the Giants over the Reds as we work here in the top half of the third inning.
I don't know how it works. You come fix it. You're concerned so much about it.
And Clemens fouling that one off. Count now even at 2-2. And 2-2 pitch, and Clemens goes chasing after that one. Strike three. And for Scott, that's his sixth strikeout already recorded in this game. And it represents the first out here in the top half of the third inning. Now at the plate, Will Schnatterly, and he'll foul off the first pitch here from Scott. Schnatterly walked to start the top half of the second inning. He's the seventh Giant to bat here in the third. They got the scoreboard working again. And Scott's 0-1 here to Schnatterly in there for another strike. Count now at 0-2. Now Scott's 0-2 to Schnatterly in there for strike three. So Scott rebounding back with back-to-back strikeouts, sending down Clemens and Schnatterly, and now two away with the bases still loaded here in the top half of the third inning, and the Giants leading the Reds by a score of 2-1, and Logan Halton coming to the plate. Halton also drew a walk back in the second inning. He's playing right center field today for the Giants. First pitch here from Scott to Halton is outside for ball one. Wind continuing to gust. And that pitch will check swing and glove down by the first baseman, Cyrus Potkel, for the third out of the inning. So for the third straight inning, the Giants strand three. They've stranded nine men through three innings, but they now lead the Reds 2-1 here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Back here at the Beaner Field in Hopwood, moving to the bottom half of the third inning. The Giants now leading the Reds by a score of 2-1. The Reds with the top of the order due up. Carson Scott, Jaden Ringer, and Thatcher Wilson. Reds picked up one run in the bottom half of the second inning. Carson Scott leading off this bottom half of the third. We'll swing at the first pitch and pop it up in the infield. Getting under it but unable to make the grab there is Darren Dunn. So Scott reaching. Now Jaden Ringer coming to the plate. And Scott showed early on that he was very aggressive on the base paths. Turned the corner after his opening single. And the Giants got him going back to the first base bag. See how aggressive he gets out there again this time. Swing and a miss there out of Ringer. Schnatterly working quickly. Next pitch on the way, and a swing and a miss for Ringer. Three pitches, three strikes. Schnatterly to Ringer, and Ringer rung up. Third strikeout of the game for Schnatterly, and one out here in the bottom half of the third. Now at the plate, Thatcher Wilson. He'll swing at the first pitch and pop it up, and the ball lands foul. Catcher Thomas Rankin lost that one up there behind the screen. Who would have thought he actually could have made a play on it? One strike now on Wilson. Next pitch from Schnatterly, and Wilson fouls it off. Count now at 0-2. Now Schnatterly's 0-2 to Wilson. And there for strike three, runner going, throw down, and the throw is high of second base. So a stolen base there for Carson Scott. He's in scoring position, but now two outs here in the bottom half of the third inning with Cyrus Potkle coming to the plate. First pitch to Potkle in there for a strike, 0-1. Scott dancing off the bag there at second. Oh, one pitch to Potkle. Pitch misses outside. Count now even at 1-1. That pitch ruled outside. Now Schnatterly's 2-1 to Potkle. Potkle fouls it off the mask of our home plate umpire, Nick Lancaster. He's all right. Count now 2-2. 2-2 pitch on the way, misses low and outside. Go full 3-2, Schnatterly to Potkle. And a 3-2 on the way, and it's a line drive at second. Play made by Darren Dunn over to first to Hunter Bosley for the third out of the inning. So the Reds strand Carson Scott. Still a 2-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. And we'll head to the top of the fourth here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Diane Zinn is a lifelong resident of this area and has been a full-time real estate agent for 20 years. She is an associate broker at Coldwell Banker Laurel Ridge Realty and has been a multi-million dollar producer agent. Considering a relocation to our area, Diane can be helpful in specific areas that might be of interest to you, guiding you in buying that perfect home for your family and providing mortgage avenues for financing your dream home. If you need a market value for your home, this service is also provided with the knowledge that only a full-time realtor can provide in our current sales market. Diane will take the necessary time to help you find that ultimate dream home and will also take the time to market your home to get the best possible market value for you. Look for a full-time realtor with integrity, professionalism, and the knowledge of the real estate market. Call Diane Zinn today at 724-437-7100.
Moving now to the top half of the fourth inning, a 2-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. New pitcher for the Reds, Jaden Ringer. Carson Scott, who was pitching, now playing shortstop. It's Colton Masiko, Darren Dunn, and Jaden Tucker due up for the Giants here in the top half of the fourth inning. Tucker, check that, Ringer completing his last couple of warm-up tosses. Reds get the balls in. We'll get set to resume. And Colton Masiko will lead things off. He grounded into a fielder's choice in his first at-bat back in the second inning. First pitch here, Ringer to Masiko. Masiko, first pitch swinging, sends it into left field. So a leadoff single for Masiko, and he's looking for two. And the ball comes loose, and Masiko gets back on the first base bag. So a single to left for Colton Masiko to lead off this top half of the fourth inning. And the Giants in business with Darren Dunn coming to the plate. Dunn struck out swinging in his first at-bat back in the second inning. First pitch here, high from Ringer. Over the head of Scala. There's Masiko down to second in the scoring position. So a good start for the Giants here in the top half of the fourth inning. Swing and a miss there out of Dunn. The Giants certainly have been busy getting men on base in this game. They've stranded nine through three innings. They have managed to score two runs. Another pitch missing there to Dunn. Count at 2-1. Swing and a miss there from Dunn. Count now even at 2-2. Now the 2-2 on the way. Dunn stays alive, fouling it off. Now the 2-2 on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. Ball gets away again from Scala, and there's Masiko down to third. First strikeout of the game for Ringer. And the eighth for Reds pitchers. Big swing there from Jaden Tucker. Couldn't get a piece of the ball. Counted 0-1. Tucker walked back in the second inning. Next pitch inside. Count even at 1-1. Give Carson Scott credit. Ended up with seven strikeouts through three innings of work. Another big cut there from Tucker. Count at 1-2. And Tucker, a big guy. If he can get a hold of one, look out. 1-2 pitch on the way. Tucker stays alive, fouling it back, and lost the bat too. Count remains 1-2. One 2 pitch there low. Count now even at 2-2. They've lost the scoreboard again. This time it's went completely out. 2-2 pitch high. We're full of 3-2. Jaden Ringer to Jaden Tucker. The Giants with Colton Masiko on third. One out as we work here in the top half of the fourth inning. Giants leading it 2-1. Payoff pitch on the way. Tucker stays alive, fouling it off, and again lost the bat and caught the home plate umpire Nick Lancaster with it. Nick a little dinged up there. He's going to come over and have a little talk here with Luke Wallace. They're going to warn Tucker, hey, you got to hang on to the bat. Is that his warning, Luke? And a warning issued there. You can tell looking at Nick Lancaster, that one hurt quite a bit. Nick will shake it off, we'll resume, and that pitch is low. That should be ball four, it is. So for the second time in this game, Tucker walks. Now runners on the corners with Matt Venick coming to the plate. Venick swinging a miss there, strike one. Venick playing left field here today. The one on the way, pitch is high. Count even at 1-1. One pitch, swing and a miss, strike two. Now the 1-2 outside. Evens the count at 2-2. Ringer to Venick. Two two, just missed. Got now full of 3-2. That pitch is low for ball four. So that'll load up the bases again for the Giants. Boy, we've seen this before. And the Giants have stranded 9 through 3 innings, even though they managed to score 2 runs. And here once again, the bases loaded with 1 out. You're in the top half of the fourth inning, and Hunter Bosley at the plate swings at the first pitch and sends it in a right field. Zelig Redmond is there to field the ball for the Reds, but two Giants will score. They'll look to plate another one here as Venick comes to the plate. He'll score, and now Bosley looking to come across. He'll come across as well. An unconventional inside the park home run. After some fielding trouble there on the red side. So the Giants opening up this game, scoring 4. And the lead now at 6-1. Now Evan Petrovich at the plate. The lead now at 6-1 for the Giants over the Reds as we work here in the top half of the fourth inning. And Ringer now having some trouble finding the strike zone, delivering here to Evan Petrovich. Already has a pair of singles, stole a base, and scored a run. Now he'll walk. And Brody Pavlicko will be the seventh Giant to bat here in the top half of the fourth inning. He'll swing and miss to the first pitch here from Ringer. Next pitch on the way, chop foul by Pavlicko, Pavlicko. With Petrovich on first. Pavlicko's reached base twice in this game, was hit by a pitch back in the first inning, infield single in the third. And he'll pop this one up here. And getting under it and making the grab, the third baseman, Matt Schwartzfeger. No, good job there by Matt to make the grab for the second out of the inning. Now Thomas Rankin will be the eighth Giant to come to the plate here in the top of the fourth. With Petrovich on first. And swinging at the first pitch and picking up another hit is Thomas Rankin. Single to left field. The second hit of the evening. Now runners on first and second for the Giants. And Aaron Broadwater coming to the plate. Broadwater's walked twice already in this game. And on the second walk, he picked up an RBI as he walked with the bases loaded in the third inning. He'll be the ninth Giant to bat here on the top half of the fourth. And a swing and miss the first pitch here from Ringer. Gill one, swing and a miss, strike two. Now two strikes on Aaron Broadwater as the Reds look to get out of the inning, an inning that has seen their team already concede four runs. 0-2 pitch, misses low and outside, runners though advancing. Rankin down to second, Petrovich down to third. Now a 1-2 counts. Ringer to Broadwater, and Broadwater swinging a miss, strike three. So the Giants strand two here in the fourth, where they pick up four runs. So now the Giants six, Reds one, as we move to the bottom half of the fourth inning here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Just sit right down and you hear a tale of a fateful call. You better pay those bills right now or you take a mighty fall. He really didn't know what to do, so he turned to those who did. Zeppeli, Mahalov, and White, your bankruptcy crew. Your bankruptcy crew. So no matter how deep in debt you are, if your back's against the wall, Zeppeli, Mahalov, and White, just give them.
Welcome back to the Beaner Field here in Hopwood. The Giants making a number of defensive changes. Among them, a new pitcher. And Thomas Rankin, Hunter Bosley now catching. Darren Dunn playing first. Logan Holton playing second. And Aaron Broadwater taking Holton's place out there in right center field. The Reds with Grant Scala leading off this bottom half of the fourth inning. The Giants now on top by a score of 6-1 after they plated four runs in the top half of the fourth inning. Scala fouling off that pitch. He had an infield single, stole a base, and scored a run for the Reds back in the second inning. And the Reds need a big inning here to try to get back into this game. Rankin's pitch there, missing outside. I believe the count now at 2-1. Rankin to Scala. And Scala popping this one up. And making the grab. A nice play there by Logan Holton. That was a tough grab for Holton. Backing up to the edge of the grass. Deep in the infield to make the grab for the first out of this bottom half of the fourth inning. Now Matt Schwartzfeger coming to the plate. Schwartzfeger grounded out, three unassisted back in the second inning. Took ball one from Rankin. Swing and a miss there, and we're even at 1-1. Nick Lancaster, home plate umpire, still shaking off his wrist after he got hit on the bat of Jaden Tucker back in the top half of the fourth inning. Two strikes now on Schwartzfeger here. Now the 1-2 from Rankin. It's high and inside. Good job there by the catcher Bosley to glove that one down. Count now even at 2-2. Now the 2-2 on the way, and a line drive that gets through on the right side. So a single to right for Schwartzfeger. And the Reds in business, down 5. Here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Ryan Kiefover coming to the plate. Rankin's first pitch here to Kiefover. Misses for ball one. Now the 1-0, and that's a ground ball to second. Holton is there, makes the flip over to the shortstop Petrovic for the force out. A fielder's choice, 4-6. Getting the lead runner for the second out. On this bottom half of the fourth inning. It's actually Will Schnatterly now playing short. Another change that was made by the Giants. Near the ball getting away from the catcher Hunter Bosley. That will allow Matt Schwartzfeger to get down to second. Ty Pleben at the plate. Swing and a miss there. Count even now, 1-1. As the wind continues to gust here tonight in Hopwood. 1-1 to Pleben outside. Count out 2-1. Ball low in the dirt. Runner trying to advance and getting into third safely is Schwartzfeger. Still two outs here in the inning. Rankin missing there on the pitch to Pleben. And that's ball four. So for the second time in this game, Pleben walks. And I'll bring up Tyler Hager now with two outs and runners on the corners. And the Giants leading the Reds 6-1. Tyler Hager now coming to the plate. Rankin's first pitch to Hager in there for a strike, 0-1. Pretty good pitch there from Rankin. Now the 0-1 to Hager. Hager swing and a miss. Now two strikes on Tyler Hager. No two on the way, a one hopper. Got now 1-2. One two pitch, high and inside. Got now even at 2-2. Two two just off the plate, didn't miss by much. Now 4-3-2. Sky's darkening up a little bit here in Hopwood. 3-2 pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. So the Reds strand two. And it's still 6-1 Giants over the Reds as we head to the top half of the fifth here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer would like to wish all the HARC baseball players good luck and have a fun baseball season this year.
Back here on the South Union Township Sports Network in Hopwood at the Beaner Field. A 6-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. Scoreboard's actually still out. The coach is getting together, making sure they have the score correct. It's 6-1. The Giants scoring two runs in the third inning, four in the fourth. The Reds plating their only run back in the second inning. It's Parker Clements, Will Schnatterly, and Logan Holton due up for the Giants here in the top half of the fifth. Clements at the plate has struck out twice already today. Swings here and sends this in a shallow right center. Tyler Hager charging on, but a leadoff single to right center field for Parker Clements. And the Giants in business here in the top half of the fifth. Now Will Schnatterly at the plate. Schnatterly check swing, sends it foul. Counted 0-1. Schnatterly walked back in the second inning. Struck out looking in the third. Count 0-1 here. And the Giants have sent at least six men to the plate in every inning so far today. And Schnatterly is shot there, getting through right up the middle. And the Giants staying aggressive on the base paths, is sliding into third is Parker Clements. A single from Will Schnatterly. Now runners on first and third and nobody out for the Giants here in the top half of the fifth. The Giants leading this one 6-1. Logan Holton now at the plate. Takes the first pitch outside, again gets away from the catcher Scala, throw down to second and there safely is Will Schnatterly. Six men came to the plate for the Giants in the first inning. Sent another six men to the plate in the second inning as Holton swings and misses there. But in both the first and second innings, the Giants unable to pick up any runs. The Giants then sent eight men to the plate in the third inning, scored two runs, and sent nine men to the plate, plating four runs in the fourth inning. Another swing and a miss out of Holton there. Now two strikes on Logan Holton. And here in the fifth, Clements and Schnatterly with singles. Able to advance down to second and third. And Holton trying to do some work here at the plate. Takes a ball high and inside there from Ringer. Count now at 2-2. And Ringer's 2-2 pitch. High and inside again to Holton. We'll go 4-3-2 with first base now open. And the payoff pitch, Ringer to Holton. Holton swing and a miss, strike three. That's the first out recorded here in the top half of the fifth inning. Now Colton Masico coming to the plate. Masico 1-for-2 today, grounded into a fielder's choice back in the second inning. Single to left field and scored a run in the fourth. Has an opportunity here to maybe drive in a couple of runs with Clements on third and Schnatterly at second. It'll ground this one back to the pitcher, Ringer, who flips it over to first to Potkel for the out, 1-3. But Masiko picks up an RBI as it drives in Parker Clements, the seventh run scored in this game for the Giants. And the lead now at 7-1. And now at the plate, Darren Dunn swings to the first pitch and sends it foul on the left side. Dunn struck out twice already in this game. Comes to the plate here with Will Schnatterly on third and two outs here in the top half of the fifth inning. No one pitch from Jaden Ringer is outside. Count now even at 1-1. Now the 1-1 pitch on the way, low and in the dirt. Count now 2-1. This one popped up by Dunn. And the Reds allowing the ball to bounce foul. Well, miscommunication there between Schwartzfeger and Ringer. Someone needs to take charge out there on the red side. Next pitch to Dunn. He'll foul it off. It's a 7-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. Next pitch is low and outside. Count out 1-2. Ringer to Dunn. That pitch outside. Actually, must have been 3-2. Scoreboard showing 1-2. Missed a couple of balls along the way. So Dunn with a walk. With runners on the corners. And Jaden Tucker will come to the plate. Home plate umpire Nick Lancaster might want to take a step back right now with Tucker coming in there. Of course, Tucker caught Lancaster with his bat last time up. Swings the first pitch here and sends it foul. Count it 0-1. I think they overemphasized to Tucker to make sure he hangs on to the bat. 0-1 pitch, and Tucker with a little hopper here to second. And the tag made by Ryan Kiefover on Darren Dunn for the third out of the inning. But the Giants pick up another run and now lead it 7-1 over the Reds as we head to the bottom half of the fifth here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Moving now to the bottom half of the fifth inning, a 7-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. Here in Hopwood on the South Union Township Sports Network, Brian Morozak alongside Jerry Dupay. HARC Midget League baseball action between the Clark Giants and the HARC Reds. The Giants plating two in the top half of the third inning, four in the fourth, and adding another run here in the top half of the fifth. The Reds scoring their only run in the bottom half of the second inning. So now 7-1 with Zelig Redmond leading things off for the Reds here in the bottom half of the fifth. Swings and misses of the first pitch from Thomas Rankin, counted 0-1. Rankin's 0-1 here to Redmond, swing and a miss, strike two. Two strikes now on Redmond, who struck out back in the second inning. The 0-2 on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. So Rankin starts off the inning by sending down Redmond. And now one away with the top of the order and Carson Scott coming to the plate. Scott singled to left field back in the first inning, reached via an error in the third inning. His third plate appearance of the game. First pitch Rankin to Scott, swing and a miss from Carson, counted 0-1. Now the 0-1 pitch, swing and a miss again, counted 0-2. Now the 0-2 on the way, swing and a miss, strike three. So back-to-back strikeouts for Thomas Rankin here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. It's now three strikeouts in the game for Rankin and seven for Giants pitchers. Now Jaden Ringer coming to the plate with nobody on and two outs. Rankin's first pitch misses for ball one. We have not had a 1-2-3 inning on either side so far in this game. If Rankin retires a Ringer, we have one here in the bottom half of the fifth. 1-0 pitch, and this ball grounded right back to Rankin. Flips it over to first, over to Darren Dunn for the third out of the inning. So 1-2-3, bottom half of the fifth. Way to the top of the sixth, still 7-1, Giants over the Reds here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Diane Zinn is a lifelong resident of this area and has been a full-time real estate agent for 20 years. She is an associate broker at Coldwell Banker Laurel Ridge Realty and has been a multi-million dollar producer agent. Considering a relocation to our area, Diane can be helpful in specific areas that might be of interest to you, guiding you in buying that perfect home for your family and providing mortgage avenues for financing your dream home. If you need a market value for your home, this service is also provided with the knowledge that only a full-time realtor can provide in our current sales market. Diane will take the necessary time to help you find that ultimate dream home and will also take the time to market your home to get the best possible market value for you. Look for a full-time realtor with integrity, professionalism, and the knowledge of the real estate market. Call Diane Zinn today at 724-437-7100.
Moving now to the top half of the seventh inning, or top half of the sixth inning, excuse me. Matt Venick, Hunter Bosley, and Evan Petrovich due up for the Giants. Giants leading the Reds by a score of 7-1. A couple of defensive changes for the Reds, including a new pitcher. The new pitcher is Grant Scala. Misses on the first pitch inside to Matt Venick. Down at 1-0. Now the 1-0 in for a strike. Even the count at 1-1. 1-1 on the way. Swing and a miss. Two strikes now on Matt Venick. Mentioned Grant Scala now pitching. Cyrus Potkel's the new catcher. Carson Scott playing first. And Jaden Ringer, who was on the mound back in the fifth inning, now playing shortstop. That one fouled off there by Venick. To 7-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. Pitch is low. Evens the count at 2-2. Scala to Venick. And 2-2 inside. We go full 3-2. And there's strike three. A good start defensively for the Reds here in the top half of the sixth. Now the top of the order for the Giants as Hunter Bosley will come to the plate for the fourth time in this game. Bosley swings and misses here at the first pitch from Grant Scala. Bosley cleared the bases and scored himself in his last plate appearance. A little nubber here, just going foul down the first baseline. Don't think he'd traditionally scored an inside the park home run. There are a couple of defensive issues the Reds had. But nonetheless, Bosley productive. He's already scored two runs now in this game. And sends a hard ground ball fair down the first baseline. Bosley rounding first on his way to second. Now he's going to head to third. They finally got the ball out of the corner. And Bosley colliding there with the Reds' third baseman, Schwartzfeger. And he has a triple to right field. Now Evan Petrovich coming to the plate. And Petrovich ducks out of the first pitch there from Grant Scala. One oh on the way, again inside. Counted 2-0. The 2-0, hard ground ball down the third baseline. It's fair. Schwartzfeger boots it into foul territory. Well, goes the hit for Evan Petrovich. Driving in Hunter Bosley. RBI for Petrovich. Run scored for Bosley. He's now scored three runs in this game. The lead now at 8-1 for the Giants over the Reds. And Brody Pavlico coming to the plate, and he gets one through on the left side. Petrovich down to second. Another single for the Giants and Pavlico. As they try to add to their 8-1 lead. You're in the top half of the sixth inning. Now Thomas Rankin at the plate. Rankin swings and misses at the first pitch. Gets away there from the catcher, Potkel. Runners advance. Pavlico down to second. Petrovich down to third. And Thomas Rankin at the plate. Next pitch from Scala. Rankin, another shot went off of Scala. Hit him in the knee into right field. Another pair of runs will score here for the Giants, coming across Petrovic and Pavlico. Sliding into second is Thomas Rankin. Now they'll check on the pitcher, Grant Scala, after he was caught with that hard ground ball. The lead now at 10-1. The Giants over the Reds. They'll let Scala throw one here and just make sure he's all right. Seems fine with that delivery. Gives the thumbs up. Good sportsmanship there out of Rankin. Now Aaron Broadwater at the plate. He's walked twice, picked up an RBI, also struck out in his last plate appearance back in the fourth. First pitch here from Scala misses high for ball one. Boy, the Giants looking sharp here tonight. Came into this game with a 2-2 record. And up here on the Reds, 10-1. Swing and a miss there from Broadwater. Throw down to third. Hops away there from Schwarzfeger. In the left field. Next pitch to Broadwater. Inside. Count out 2-1. Scale it to Broadwater. As we work here in the top half of the sixth inning. That one in the dirt. Aaron throw there. Count up to 3-1. As the Reds that struck first, though, in this game, plating a run in the bottom half of the second inning. It's been all Giants since. And a 3-1 on the way, fouled off by Broadwaters. So we'll go full of 3-2. The Giants with two across in the third, four in the fourth. Another run in the fifth now, three already across here in the sixth. 3-2 pitch. And there for strike three. So Broadwater strikes out for the second time in this game. It's also the second strikeout for Scala. And two away here in the top half of the sixth inning. With Parker Clements coming to the plate. Clements 1-for-3 with a run scored. First pitch low and outside for ball one. And 1-0 there is high for ball two. That pitch low and outside. Scala now struggling a little bit to find the strike zone. On the way, and there for a strike, count of 3-1. Three-one pitch. This ball hits a short. Ringer makes the throw. Over to first in time. They're going to rule Clements out at first. 6-3. Solid fundamentals there out of the Reds. The Giants pick up another three runs. It's now a 10-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. Reds down to their final 3 outs. When we come back here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer would like to wish all the HARC baseball players good luck and have a fun baseball season this year.
Back Back here in Hopwood at the Beaner Field, heading to the bottom half of the sixth inning. A 10-1 lead for the Giants over the Reds. Couple of Reds saying hello down below. New pitcher Hunter Bosley for the Giants. Crafty lefty. First pitch outside for ball one to Thatcher Wilson. Third plate appearance of the game for Wilson. He struck out a pair of times so far. And the 1-0 here, in there for a strike to even the count at 1-1. Next pitch low and outside. Count now at 2-1. Another low one there from Bosley. Count now 3-1. And now a walk issued to Thatcher Wilson. So Wilson aboard for the first time in this game. And Cyrus Potko will come to the plate. Swinging and fouling off the first pitch there is Potkel. Tom Rankin telling his pitcher Hunter Bosley, just throw strikes at this point of the game. You're up 9. You're in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Bosley missing there. The Giants just need 3 outs. And it'll improve to 3-2 on the season. That ball getting away there from the Giants catcher and heading down to second base to Thatcher Wilson. Pitch outside and again getting away. A little collision down there at third. There's Jaden Tucker and Thatcher Wilson get together. Well, Schnatterly is now the Giants catcher. They've made a couple of defensive changes as well. Hard ground ball there from Potkel gets through. And that will play Thatcher Wilson. And Potkel on his way to second, now on his way to third. Throw from Broadwater goes right in between the wickets of Jaden Tucker. And now Potkel headed to the plate. He'll score. So what ended up is a single to right. Ends up as a run scored for Cyrus Potkel. And just like that, the Reds pick up 2 runs here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Showing a lot of fight here. Now down 10-3. And Grant Scala coming to the plate. Scala swings and misses the first pitch from Hunter Bosley. Now Bosley's 0-1 to Scala, swinging a miss, strike 2. Now Bosley regrouping. 0-2 to Scala, hit him in the back. So the Reds still with life. Get Scala on board. Matt Schwartzfeger coming to the plate. First pitch, Bosley to Schwartzfeger. Ground ball here to second, and it gets past Vanek in a right field. And the Giants run Scala back to second. So now runners on first and second here for the Reds. The score 10-3. And Ryan Kiefover coming to the plate. Reds showing a lot of fight here in this bottom half of the sixth inning. Kiefover taking ball one from Hunter Bosley. Now the 1-0. is outside, count at 2-0. Pitch outside again, hops away from the catcher Schwartz Figger. Check that. Matt Schnatterly, the catcher now for the Giants. And the runners advancing down to second and third. Next pitch to Kiefover. Another hard line drive that actually hit the runner, so he'll be out. The run will score on the play. Scala scores. Schwartzfeger was hit. So that'll be the first out of the inning. And Kiefover safe on first. And Ty Pleben coming to the plate. Score now 10-4. As Wilson, Potkel, and Scala have all scored runs for the Reds here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Next pitch to Pleben inside. Pleben went down, did not catch him. And one correction, they actually sent Scala back to third. So the score's still at 10-3, and you have Scala on third and Kiefover on first. Pleben at the plate. And they count 3-1. Bosley to Pleben. That pitch outside for ball four, and that'll load up the bases. Now, the reason Scala was not allowed to score on that last play was on third base, but when the ball hit the runner Schwartzfeger, the play was essentially whistled down, and Scala had to go back to third. So the base is loaded, and Tyler Hager coming to the plate. He'll take ball one outside there from Bosley. Next pitch on the way, again outside. Count out 2-0. On the way inside, count out 3-0. A 3-0 pitch in there for a strike, count of 3-1. There's ball four. That walks Tyler Hager and walks in a run. As Grant Scala will now score, and it's 10-4. Three across now for the Reds here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. And Zelig Redmond now coming to the plate. First pitch here to Redmond, high for ball one. Redmond is now the eighth Red to bat here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Takes a couple of pitches now from Hunter Bosley, who's struggling to find the strike zone. He's walked back-to-back men in Pleben and Hager. Needs to throw strikes here to Redmond, and now hits Redmond on the elbow. Actually, might have caught him in the ribs there. And Redmond now down. Another run will score as Kiefover comes across. It'll load up the bases. Good to see Redmond all right. Four runs have now scored here in the inning. And the score is a 10-5. On the top of the order, and Carson Scott now coming up. We're going to have a pitching change here for the Giants. We'll step aside for a quick timeout. This one not over yet. 10-5. Reds over the Giants. Or Giants over the Reds, excuse me. But it's the Reds threatening here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind, we're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Now 10-5, Carson Scott at the plate for the Reds. The base is loaded, game tying run on the on deck circle, one out, bottom of the sixth, 10-5, Giants over the Reds. Scott swings and misses at the first pitch from Evan Petrovich. It was the new pitcher on the mound for the Giants, Hunter Bosley, who was pitching now out in right field. And that pitch catching Scott. And the Reds score another run. So Ty Pleben scores. It's now 10-6. Five runs across here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Now Jaden Ringer coming to the plate. He's the 10th Red to bat here in the bottom of the sixth. No swing and foul back the first pitch from Evan Petrovich. And despite the fact that the Reds have sent 10 men to the plate, they have only one hit here in the inning. That was the Potkul single. The rest have been guys either walked or hit by pitches. And a couple of errors in the field as well. Next pitch on the way and a ground ball here to second. Halton is there, but the throw not in time and goes over the head of the first baseman Dunn. It's actually Broadwater playing first, but now Broadwater trying to catch Ringer out of position. They're going to roll Ringer safe back at first. Wow. And also down at third, Tyler Hager fell on the play, or he would have scored. So the Reds have batted around. Thatcher Wilson back at the plate. It's now 10-7. And a swing and a miss there out of Wilson. That pitch in there for a strike. Now two strikes on Wilson. That pitch inside. There's swing and a miss, strike three. Yeah, it is strike three. A little delay there.
Come on, Cyrus,
let's go! It is strike three there on Wilson. So two away. It's a 10-7 game. Scoreboard showing 10-6, but it is 10-7. Giants over the Reds. And Potkul at the plate with the bases loaded. He'll swing and miss here at the first pitch from Petrovich. And now the 0-1 on the way. Low and in the dirt, even the count at 1-1. The 1-1, line drive, right side, glove down there by Holt. The throw goes wide. Two runs score on the play. And it's now 10-9. The game tying run is now on third base for the Reds. And Grant Scala at the plate. Scala swings and misses at the first pitch, 0-1. And there's a ground ball on the left side, glove down, throw over to first, not in time, and we're tied at 10. The Reds have scored 9 runs here in the 6th inning. This would be the comeback of all comebacks. Matt Schwartz figuring out the plate. 2 outs here in the inning. This could win it for the Reds. And the Reds were down 10-1 entering this inning. And a ground ball here just going foul. I don't think many folks would have thought we'd be playing possibly extras with a 10-1 score headed to the bottom of the 6th. But Schwartzfeger has an opportunity to end it here for the Reds. Pitch from Petrovic. Oh, and just fouled off. Now 2 strikes on Schwartzfeger. Now the 1-2 on the way, swing it and miss strike 3. So we're headed to extra innings. Tied at 10 between the Giants and the Reds here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Diane Zinn is a lifelong resident of this area and has been a full-time real estate agent for 20 years. She is an associate broker at Coldwell Banker Laurel Ridge Realty and has been a multi-million dollar producer agent. Considering a relocation to our area, Diane can be helpful in specific areas that might be of interest to you, guiding you in buying that perfect home for your family and providing mortgage avenues for financing your dream home. If you need a market value for your home, this service is also provided with the knowledge that only a full-time realtor can provide in our current sales market. Diane will take the necessary time to help you find that ultimate dream home and will also take the time to market your home to get the best possible market value for you. Look for a full-time realtor with integrity, professionalism, and the knowledge of the real estate market. Call Diane Zinn today at 724-437-7100.
Heading out of the top of the 7th inning after the Reds scored 9 runs in the bottom of the 6th. Schnatterly ground ball there, glove down and retired. Strong defensive play there from Carson Scott. Recording the out, 3 unassisted. Now 1 away. With Logan Holton coming to the plate. Holton swings and fouls back the first pitch from Scala. And certainly all the momentum in this game with the Reds. And pitch high and inside. One on the way, just foul tipped there by Holton. Count at 1-2. One-two pitch outside. Count now even at 2-2. Now the 2-2 pitch. Just misses off the plate. And count full of 3-2. One out as we work here in the top of the 7th inning. And there's strike three. Just like that, two away here in the top of the seventh. And Colton Masico coming to the plate here for the Giants. First pitch low and in the dirt for ball one. Next pitch inside. A 2-0 now. Scala to Masico. Swing and a miss there. Count it 2-1. That one high and inside. Count it 3-1. Swing and a miss. We're full of 3-2. Now the payoff pitch, and this ball goes over the head of Schwartzfeger in the left field. So a one-out single to left for Colton Masico, and the Giants in business with two outs here in the top of the seventh, and Darren Dunn coming to the plate. Scala's first pitch to Dunn is outside for ball one. Now the 1-0, off the plate again, 2-0. Donna swing and a miss there, count it 2-1. And Colton Masico on first, two outs. Here in the top of the seventh, tied at 10. That ball getting away there from the catcher, Potkul. Dunn golfing that one foul. Count now 4-3-2. Payoff pitch on the way. Dunn swinging a miss, strike three. So the Reds an opportunity to win it now. In the bottom half of the seventh inning, tied at 10. Reds and Giants, HARC Midget League action here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Ryan Kiefover to lead things off for the Reds here in the bottom of the seventh inning, tied at 10, Reds and Giants. Evan Petrovic still on the mound for the Giants. First pitch misses for ball one. You can hear the Reds dugout. They're fired up after they scored 9 runs in the bottom of the sixth inning to extend this game to extra innings. 1-0 pitch, and this ball hit in the air to right center field and making the grab. The right center fielder, Aaron Broadwater. Nice catch there. And one out.
Hey, Ron, that was a
Now Ty Plevin coming to the plate. First pitch to Plevin, high for ball one. Another pitch inside to Plevin. Now into their first strikeout, now 2-1. Petrovic to Plevin. Now two strikes on Ty Plevin. Count it 2-2. That one just fouled off. Right off the mask of the Giants catcher, Will Schnatterly. Another two strike pitch. Inside, and we'll go full 3-2. And a 3-2 pitch on the way, in there for strike three. Big pitch there from Evan Petrovic. Now Tyler Hager will come to the plate. First pitch to Hager, high for ball one. The 1-0 in there for a strikeout, now even at 1-1. Count now 1-2. Now Petrovic is 1-2 to Hager. Inside, we might be looking at another extra inning. Might be headed to the eighth. Two, two on the way, and that's ruled strike three. So back-to-back strikeouts for Petrovic, sending down Plevin and Hager. And we're going to head to the top half of the eighth. Tied at 10, Giants and Reds. HARC Midget League action here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Jaden Tucker, Matt Venick, and Hunter Bosley do up for the Giants here in the top half of the eighth. They're just joining us. This was a 10-1 game, a 10-1 lead for the Giants heading to the bottom half of the sixth inning when the Reds send 14 men to the plate and score 9 runs. And after a scoreless seventh inning, now here in the top half of the eighth, Jaden Tucker, who's reached base safely in 2 of 3 plate appearances, will try to get things started here for the Giants. Grant Scala is still on the mound for the Reds. Scala missing on his first two pitches there to Tucker. 2-0 outside. Count now at 3-0. Rio pitch, inside for ball four. So Jaden Tucker drawing the walk. And the Giants in business here to start the top half of the eighth. Now Matt Venick coming to the plate. Venick walked and scored a run in the fourth inning, also struck out a pair of times in this game. And the first pitch here is high for ball one. I think certainly cooling off. Rain cell on its way into southwestern Pennsylvania. Next pitch to Venick, swing and a miss there. Count at 2-1. Now Scala set, 2-1 to Venick. Off the plate, count now at 3-1. And a 3-1 pitch is high for ball four, so back-to-back walks issued by Grant Scala. Jaden Tucker and Matt Venick reaching, now the top of the order, and Hunter Bosley coming to the plate. Bosley 3-for-4 in this game. He has 4 RBIs and 3 runs scored. Trying to add to it right here. Swings at the first pitch, pops it up, and the ball is caught. A nice job there by Jaden Ringer to retire Bosley for the first out of this top half of the eighth. Now Evan Petrovich will come to the plate. Petrovich has reached base safely in all 4 of his plate appearances. 3 singles, also walked. Has scored a pair of runs in this game. Swings at the first pitch here, pops it up in the infield, and a nice job to take charge there from the pitcher, Grant Scala, to retire Petrovich for the second out of the inning. And now Brody Pavlicko will come to the plate. Brody 2-for-3 in this game, was also hit by a pitch and scored a run. The first pitch here, low for ball one, hops away from the catcher. Potkel will throw down to third. They should have him there, but no. Ball was dropped on the throwdown there by Schwartzfeger. Safe at third is Jaden Tucker. Now runners on second and third. Swing and a miss there from Pavlicko. A 1-1 pitch, low and outside. Count now at 2-1. And 2-1 on the way, well hit ball. Unable to get gloved down there by Thatcher Wilson. It'll score 2 runs here for the Giants. Throw down back to second, goes into center field. Tucker and Venick already scored, and Pavlicko's now down at third. Brody Pavlicko, a 2-RBI single to left center field. Tucker and Venick scoring. It's now 12-10 Giants. Give them a lot of credit to bounce back after yielding 9 in the bottom half of the sixth. Now Thomas Rankin coming to the plate. Rankin swings to the first pitch and golfs this one fair over Schwartzfeger's head into left field. And Rankin on his way to second with a double. An RBI double for Thomas Rankin. Runs scored for Pavlicko. 3 across for the Giants here in the top half of the eighth. It's now 13-10. And Aaron Broadwater coming to the plate. Remember, the Reds will still have their crack at things in the bottom half of the eighth. And what's 3 runs to them after they scored 9 in the bottom half of the sixth? That pitch inside to Broadwater, again getting away from Potkel. Throw down to third, and that ball will go into left center field. And Rankin's down to third base. been one of the wilder Midget League games we've seen out here over the years. Swing and a miss there from Broadwater. Really shows for all you youngsters out there, never give up. This one popped up, and the catch made by Ryan Kiefover to end the inning. But the Giants pick up three here in the top half of the eighth. It's the Giants 13, the Reds 10. And the Reds will get their crack at it in the bottom half of the eighth when we come back here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Zelik Redmond leading things off for the Reds here in the bottom half of the eighth. Now 13-10 Giants over the Reds. And a wild Midget League game tonight in Hopwood. Redmond 0 for 2 today, was also hit by a pitch. Back in the sixth inning, picked up an RBI when he was hit. Takes the first pitch here, low for ball one from Edvin Petrovich. Now the 1-0. High for ball two. Got now a 2-0. And 2-0 pitch, swing and a miss there from Redmond. Count at 2-1. That pitch high and inside. Count now 3-1. Three-one on the way, fouled back. Good cut there from Redmond. Redmond focused. Payoff pitch from Petrovich. Redmond swing and a miss, strike three. So one away by the top of the order now up in Carson Scott. Scott's had a busy evening. Single to left field in the first, reached via an error in the third, struck out swinging in the fifth, was hit by a pitch and scored a run in the sixth. And fouls one off here. Reds down three, down to their final two outs. No one pitch from Petrovich. Ruled strike two. Scott thought it was inside. And two strikes on Carson Scott. That pitch a one hopper. Got out 1-2. One, two on the way. Inside again. Got out 2-2. Two on the way, and Scott sends it foul. Two pitch here, inside, so we'll go 4-3-2. Payoff pitch. Scott ropes this one fair down the left field line. This ball going all the way back to the wall. Scott, plenty of speed, rounding second on his way to third. Here comes the throw. Scott's going to go from third on his way to the plate, and they'll tag him out. So the Reds down three, aggressive on the base paths, and Scott almost had an inside the park home run. Good job there by the catcher, Schnatterly, to tag out Scott at home. But it goes in the books, a triple for Scott out at home, two outs now in the inning, and Jaden Ringer at the plate. I like the call, though. Why not bring him home at that point? Now with two outs in the inning, Ringer needs to get aboard to extend this game. And Ringer here, a line drive, glove down, to end the game. Now what a game it was. It went eight innings. The Reds scoring nine in the bottom half of the sixth to extend it to extras, but the Giants with three in the top half of the eighth end up taking the game 13-10. The Giants scored two in the top of the third, two in the fourth, one in the fifth, three in the sixth, and three in the eighth. The Reds with one in the second and one in the, and nine, excuse me, in the sixth for their 10 runs. Again, your final score, the Clark Giants 13 and the HARC Reds 10. Tonight's game was brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring Township Supervisors Bob Schiffbauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband, Armstrong Cable, and our friends at CUTV. I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay. This has been a South Union Township Sports Network presentation.